And tonight on 2-on-1 with Mike and Mike, we'll recap with East Islip coach Mike Longobardi on the Redmen's victory over Hauppauge.
Welcome to 2-on-1 with Mike and Mike. I'm your host, Michael Vetrano, with my partner in crime, Michael Torriero. Our next guest is a pride of Islip. He's a current head coach of East Islip. That's Michael Longobardi. How are you, Mike?
Hey, I'm doing well, guys. Thank you for having me on. I'm such a huge fan of your show. I love it. Again, thank you for having me on.
Well, that's good to know. At least somebody's watching, Mike.
Somebody's watching. You're right, Mike.
So, Mike, obviously we have a lot to talk about, but I want to, you know, first go over your big win. You guys beat Hauppauge over the weekend, 40-20. For those that don't follow wrestling in Suffolk, Hauppauge is a defending county champ from last year. They're also ranked number 1 in the state at one point last year. I believe they had 4 county finalists. I mean, that's a big deal, Mike. That's a huge win, 40-20.
I mean, yeah, we had a great match. You know, obviously, you know, going into the match, we thought we had the better team, you know, only because our guys just fell into the right weight classes. And, you know, it was just, you know, obviously this year is so different, but going in blind because there was no certifications this year and no one really knew anyone's roster, you know, the first match. And, you know, all of our guys just fell into the right weight classes, like I said, and, you know, we just matched up well with them. You know, they had the 4 studs, obviously, and, you know, 4 All-State kids, I think they would be this year. And, you know, going into that, I told my guys all week, you know, just wrestle 6 minutes. If you can wrestle 6 minutes with those guys, you know, you're shaving points for the team. And, you know, we gave up a couple of majors, I think 1 tech, but, you know, and maybe a decision, I forget. But, you know, they wrestled 6 minutes. You know, to be honest, that's what really won the match. When their best guys couldn't pin out guys, you know, you can just see it on the bench, you know. And then we got to the heavy, you know, the heavier weights, and we sort of dominated them up top.
Yeah, Longo, look, I'm a huge fan, obviously, of your program. I'm also a fan of Coach Messina. He's got over 500 wins. I believe he's the winningest coach in New York State. He's one of the winningest coaches in the U.S. So anytime you beat Hauppauge, it's a huge deal, right? You know, that was a home match for them. I can't remember the last time that they lost at home. I believe the last time you guys beat them was 2013. But, you know, something that sticks out of me, we talked about it over the weekend, is the box score, right? So I look at the box score. You guys didn't give up any pins, right? I mean, that's huge. I mean, that's what wins don't mean. What factor do you think that played in the match?
I mean, we talked about it all week with our guys, and they just matched up with a couple of our seniors. I think it was Volpe, Marinini, and Bordeaux. And our guys are, you know, they've been around. They're experienced guys. They sort of knew they were outmatched, but, you know, the goal of the week was to get through that match without giving up, trying to give up too many points and not getting pinned. And they had our guys on the back, but they couldn't finish. And you know, the old saying is, you know, you bend, but don't break. And that's what those guys did. I mean, if you look at Mikey Manta, he wrestled our little guy, eighth grader, Logan Alfala, returning county champion there. And Logan doesn't get pinned. And you know, I don't know if you watched the video, but he may have had the first takedown. I'm not sure, but
I took a look at it. You know, it was certainly close. You know, he talked about when he was on his hands, right? Manta was on his hands. It was certainly close, but, you know.
Definitely debatable.
Sure, for sure.
But you know what? Logan's another kid. You know, I have a few kids that, you know, they're all in, man. They're all in. And when you get a few guys like that and then add a couple other pieces, you know, it just works out, you know. So we're excited. You know, Coach Espo and I, we were able to train a little earlier in the fall. Our district allowed us to do some workouts, and we sort of saw this coming. You know, when we started training a little bit after school, you know, it was like Coach Espo and Coach Ken Corcoran, which are 2 great guys to have on the staff. And, you know, we saw it coming, and then we sort of had these guys fall into the right weight classes, which obviously helps out a lot.
So speaking of, you know, getting the okay to work out early, I mean, you and I go back a long way, even if we don't go back a long way. One of my closest teammates when I was wrestling as a kid was Joe Morbillo, who was your arch nemesis. And you know, that rivalry, I was involved in some really great rivalry in my youth. Rocky Point versus Shoreham was one of them. Joe Morbillo versus Mike Longobardi was another. I mean, you guys... you competed at the highest level that Suffolk County, New York had. If one of you has won the county title, you were going to be vying for a state title. You didn't talk to each other. It's not like it was today at all. And that's not what I want to ask. I mean, I've been following you though since I've been a little kid, and I've seen what you've done just in the last 18 to 24 months, as far as putting East Islip out on Instagram. And I'm seeing the momentum that you're building, the consistency is paramount mentality that you're building. Talk a little bit about how it's gone from Guy Leggio building that wrestling room brick by brick with his hands into you taking over the reins to that program, and kind of where you guys see yourself at the end of this year, but more importantly, in 5 years, another, 10 years, if you're going to coach that long.
Okay. I love that question. And Joe Morbillo, I still have nightmares about those matches that we had, And I feel like whenever we were in a league or county tournament, and whoever won was the outstanding wrestler of the tournament, But as far as our program, man, I started in 2005 at East Islip, and, I come in and we win the counties. And, I'm like, wow, this is awesome. I think we had like 9 or 10 all county kids, a couple county champs. And then the following year, we followed that up with the second in the county, and we had a bunch of really good teams, going through the years, I just get crossed up because it's been so long, but, we had so many good wrestlers going through our program, and they're still going, like Jesse Delavecchia, he's ranked fourth in the country, third in the country, and, some websites, but, we have guys in college, we have guys, younger kids in our program, we have youth program that I've been running for the last 5 years since Leggio stepped down. And I think that helped out a lot. I have a great feeder program. We have Ken Ferry. He's an older guy that has been around the block, and he really is all in with them. My middle school coach, Ronnie Croto, he really is this next step, before they get to me. And that's what we try to encourage, just the kids, in the youth program, just to have fun with them and get them into the middle school, then eventually to the high school. And we started off with like 45 kids on the team this year, which is in COVID year, I would say a good number. But in the pipeline, Mike, we look pretty good. I have a lot of decent kids coming up, and this is their life. They love wrestling, and they're all in. And I have a few guys on the team that are like that, and guys are just buying in, and I think you're right. Maybe it was Instagram that helped out a lot, but I think it's more like their families too. Like their families are all in. We have parents that are just, they just love it. And once you wrestle, you want to get your kids involved, and especially a good program. And we're just heading in the right direction. And we saw glimpses of this last year, and we were the most improved team in the county last year. And it's just, we're just so grateful to have the season to be able to showcase what we have.
Now, Coach, Billy O'C, if you could bring up the box score, I want to point something out. I believe that you guys are certainly here to stay. That you guys are building. I think you have a young program. I mean, take a look at that box score in terms of obviously the wins and losses, but the number of under eighth graders, ninth graders, juniors, right? Obviously you have a couple of seniors, but to me, you guys are here to stay. You guys are a young program, you're doing all the right things, from the kid program to the middle school program to the high school, everything is clicking. The last question, what makes this year, taking a look at that box score, what makes this year kind of different from the last couple of years?
I see a really solid wrestler in every weight class, and which we haven't had. I mean, last year we did a little bit, and we some weight classes we were, kind of struggling in, but like this year, you can start at 102 with Dylan Astrides. I mean, he's a kid that wrestles all year. He doesn't stop. He loves wrestling. His family loves wrestling. Same thing with Logan Afella. He's an eighth grader. We brought him up as a seventh grader, and he had over 20 wins last year on varsity. He was all league kid, Shea, he was just a stud. He was all county for us last year, league champion. He's another one. He probably started wrestling when he was 4 years old in our program. And Trey, he's one of those kids that came along in middle school, and he's like best friends with with Sheyu. And, you know, it, a lot of those guys become, you know, get their friends involved. And that's Trahey's case. And, you know, he's learning and he did a great job for us. Look, you know, he only lost by a decision there. And, you know, he actually had an opportunity to win that match. But, you know, we went over that with him. And then Avitabla, he's ninth grade. We brought him up last year. And, you know, he's going to be trouble in the future. He's another kid that just loves wrestling, wrestles all year. And then Louie, he's a senior. You know, Lou was all league last year, you know, and you can see Maureen detect him, but, you know, that kid's just on a different level. Mike Clone, that kid is probably one of the hardest workers I have in the room. You know, I go to the Gold Gym, and literally every time I go there, Mike Clone is there. He's working out. He's like all in, you know. I love the kid. You know, he unfortunately matched up with Volpe. You know, Volpe was second in the county last year, but, you know, he did not give up. Obviously, you know, all of our guys did not give up. But, you know, going on to Barra, he wrestled Bordeaux. You know, Bordeaux being an all-county kid last year. And Barra, you know, it was 13-0. You know, he didn't give up the tech, didn't give up the pin. You know, he studded out. You know, he did a great job. Vetrano, hey, you know, this is Mikey's nephew, man. He's really coming along, man. He is you know, looking really good in practice and you know, showed it on the mat. You know, he had a nice takedown, you know, really great riding on top, and he's been working on that for a while. I think he was working with Jesse Delvecchio for a little bit. And, you know, it's paying off because he did a really outstanding job and pinned his kid. Dombrowski, surprisingly enough, man, he started as a ninth grader. And he just is all in. He really bought in and has been, you know, wrestling nonstop. And he's really strong at 72. So I love him. Stark, he started when he was young. He was in our kid wrestling program. And he's another one. He's 10th grade, dude. You know, like, he's another one that just really athletic. He's quick. And at 189, he, like, fits perfect for that weight class. And he may be a little lighter than 189, but it really doesn't matter. He looks really good. And Richie Lawrence, he's an all-league kid. You know, they had to forfeit to him because they didn't have a guy. But, you know, he's ranked in the county, and he's going to surprise some people. And, you know, and Vetrano, we talked about this last kid, Sebastian Regis. You know, Terry, I remember this kid's name. He's a ninth grader. He's 270, and he probably is one of the strongest kids I've ever locked hands with.
Is this right? Okay, Sebastian, yeah. Regis, I'm noting it.
Well, listen, he's one, you know, like, we're running out of time here, but, you know, Regis, right. just so you guys know at home, Regis's dad was a world champion in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, right? So he's not a guy you want to tangle with in the stands, right? So look, your lineup is here to stay. You have a lot of young guys. You have some senior leadership. We look forward to big things for the rest of the year for the EI Rebin. I know you have, I believe you have Harbor Fields, you have Hills, you have Kings Park and Compswell, right? So you guys are poised to hopefully keep the momentum going. I look forward to a lot of exciting matches on both sides, and we'll catch you on the way. That's Coach Mike Longobardi. Take care, Mike. Congrats on the big win.
All right. Thanks, guys.
Thanks, Mike.